So what is going on, everyone? This is Fabi here, and today we are here to review the Orbi RBK30. Now, this is a mesh wireless system, and it's got one router, so one main router, and an extra satellite that you can directly plug into the wall. So the reason why I actually got one of these mesh systems is because I have a pretty big house, and the router I used to have before, the Asus RTN66U, so that was a wireless N router, just wasn't really up to par for what I needed. So especially in the last year, it would cut off the connection altogether from time to time, so for a few seconds I wouldn't have internet. And of course, for web browsing that's not an issue, but when you're playing online games or you're talking on Skype or something like that, it's obviously pretty bothersome. Now, I tried flashing a different firmware on the router, I tried resetting it to its previous settings, to the factory settings, and none of that works. So I basically attributed the issue to some sort of hardware issue or something, and it was pretty old at this point. I had it for about 6 to 7 years, so I thought it was time for something new. And looking at the market for routers, I didn't find something that was quite in my price range that really ticked all the boxes. Now, obviously, Wi-Fi 6 has been kind of launched. I don't think it's actually 100% ready for the market now, and the prices for the routers and the systems that have Wi-Fi 6 are pretty steep, and the only devices that I have in my household that are Wi-Fi 6 enabled are two iPhones, so it wasn't really something that I was really ready for. So in the end, I went for this solution mainly because of the low price here in my country. I bought it for $180, which is pretty low. I think in the US it's about the same, but for where I'm at, it's a really good price. And also because I saw a lot of good reviews of it, comparing it to other mesh solutions, it was always in the top two, maybe top three of all reviews, and that basically sealed the deal for me. So who is mesh Wi-Fi for? Back in 2016, when all these mesh solutions started coming up, they were really expensive, and having this pretty large house, I always thought that mesh Wi-Fi would be pretty good for me in my situation, especially because I only have Ethernet in this room, and wiring up all the house would be a huge hassle, so having multiple wired access points is just not an option for me, unfortunately. But with the mesh Wi-Fi system, I can basically distribute the internet connection to multiple access points that are linked together via Wi-Fi, and I can have multiple just small cells around the house which can broadcast wireless signal. And that's a great benefit because I can have 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi in more places than I would before. Basically, with my old router, I would only have 5 gigahertz in my room and in the hallway next to my room, but no one was using Wi-Fi there, so it was absolutely pointless besides my room. Now, with this new solution, I can have the main router over here in my room. It's actually above my head, over on a shelf, and the secondary satellite in my living room, which is where the main TV is at, where I hang out on the weekends and I spend quite some time. And it's actually a fairly open space, so it can broadcast the signal, the 5 gigahertz signal, throughout my whole downstairs level, basically. So that's a pretty good thing. Now, what's particularly interesting about the Orbi and what makes it stick out above the others, because most of the other products on the market don't have this, is the fact that the Orbi uses a separate Wi-Fi channel just for the backhaul. So that means that it doesn't use the same channels that it uses to communicate with your devices to distribute the Wi-Fi signal to the other access points. So it's got a separate dedicated 80 megahertz 2x2 channel that it uses to communicate with the other satellites, which is basically good for around 866 megabits per second. Of course, that's theoretical. In reality, if you're gonna get about 450 to 500 megabits per second, that's really good. But because of this, the Orbi doesn't have to split up its time between communicating to the main router and then broadcasting the signal over to the devices that are communicating with it. So that really benefits the Orbi a great deal, and it's gonna show in the speed test that I'm going to run later on, and you guys are gonna see what sort of results I was getting. So basically, if you're someone like me, you have a larger than usual apartment or a house, a mesh system is going to be a must if you don't have Ethernet running to all of your rooms. And even if you have Ethernet, the Orbi is going to be a great solution because with most Orbi setups, you can run backhaul to your satellite. Now, with this particular one, the RBK30 that I have, I can't wire up the satellite, but that doesn't bother me because I don't need something like that. And also, something worth mentioning is that for the size of my house, I would say the three three access points, so one router and two satellites would probably be the best solution, but that was way more expensive over here and I just couldn't justify the price of that. Something else that was really a huge benefit for me when it comes to the Orbi was the fact that you can also tinker with some advanced settings. So for example, I can host an open VPN server on my Orbi so I can access my home network from all over the world, and I can even tunnel through my home connection so that I can access the internet as if I was at home. So basically, you know, services that are blocked in other countries when I'm traveling, I can access through the power of my own VPN. So that's a really cool addition, and I can tell you it's much, much easier to set up than it was on my previous Asus router. So it's a really seamless process that I have absolutely nothing that I can complain about. Now, what sort of speeds are we looking at with the Orbi? Something that I need to mention about the speed test is the fact that I ran three speed tests on both the old and the new network in basically about the same conditions, so low network load. Obviously, I didn't disconnect all of the devices from my network, but I made sure that no one was using the network during the testing, so that shouldn't really influence anything. The Wi-Fi channels were set the same on both the old and the new router, so that shouldn't be any difference there. And the placement of the main router was the same for the Asus and for the Orbi system. So previously in my room, in my office basically over here, I used to get an average of 225 down with 217 up on a 5 gigahertz channel. That was 5 gigahertz wireless and with 40 megahertz of spectrum. So now I'm getting 541 megabits per second down with 84.8 up using a 5 gigahertz AC wireless 80 megahertz channel. So that's quite an improvement. The only thing that sort of disappoints me is the upload speed, and I don't really know why it's lower than before and lower than even 100 megabits per second. I can understand it is not symmetric between the download and the upload, but I think the difference here is just a little bit too big to be normal, and I have to investigate that a little bit further. Going on in the upstairs bedroom, beforehand I used to have 33.3 down with 56 up, and now I have 64.8 down with 41.8 up. So this was basically on the 2.4 gigahertz of the old router and 2.4 gigahertz on the new router. This was not the satellite again, this was the main router that was handling the Wi-Fi. Now in the secondary bedroom, it's basically about the same. I used to get 56.4 down with 75.7 up. So you can notice the higher upload speeds of the old router. And on the newer one, I'm getting 64.97 down and 44.23 up. This is again with 2.4 gigahertz on both the old and the new Wi-Fi router. Again, on the main router, not the satellite. Now in the downstairs kitchen, we finally get to see the power of the secondary access point of the Orbi system. And we have much, much higher speeds on the Orbi. So with the older router, I used to get 10.75 down and 9.45 up on the old router, again 2.4 gigahertz, and with the new router I'm getting 55.37 down with 15.3 up on the new system, again on the satellite with a 2.4 gigahertz connection. Now the difference between the old speeds and the newer speeds is the fact that I can now confidently stream even 4K media down there, and I have absolutely no issues, and there's no drop in connectivity. Now with the older router, when I used to walk around the kitchen, I would just randomly drop to 4G or 3G because the Wi-Fi signal was just really bad. So with the new one, it's a constant connection, consistent, so I don't have any of those issues, which is really, really cool. And it's a place where it actually improved the speeds quite a little bit. Going on to the living room, this won't come as a surprise. This is where the satellite of the Orbi is mounted. So with the old router, I used to get 44.93 download with 33.13 up on the 2.4 gigahertz of the Asus. And now on the 5 gigahertz of the satellite, I'm getting 277.67 download with 36.83 upload. So that's just no comparison with the old router, and it really is much, much better. Outside, about 10 feet away from the house, I used to get 4.45 down with 3.85 up on the old router, again 2.4 gigahertz. Now on 5 gigahertz on the satellite, I'm getting 276.33 down with 35.53 upload. Again, 5 gigahertz on the new satellite versus 2.4 gigahertz on the old router, which was pretty far away. Going on, testing it a little bit to the extreme, this is about 60 feet away from the house in my outdoor backyard kitchenette where I also have the barbecue basically. So on the old router, absolutely no connection through my Asus router, whereas with the new one, I'm getting 24.8 down with 7.02 upload. This is not great by any means, but it means that I can stream 1080p comfortably. I can use voice over Wi-Fi. I can use all sorts of services without any interruption. Only if I want to download something, it's a little bit of a drawback, but other than that, it's great. Again, this is on the 2.4 gigahertz of the satellite, so that's basically it. Now, testing it over Ethernet, I get about 900 megabits down with around 500 megabits up. This is basically the speed that I'm getting from my ISP, so I can't really ask for more. It's flawless. With the old one, I used to have to actually flash a custom firmware because with the original firmware, it wouldn't go over 200 to 300 megabits per second on Ethernet. And I also had to disable QoS because that was just destroying all of the speeds, but now it's just flawless. Now, setting it up and using the application is quite straightforward. Again, with the web interface, you do have a few more options, which is something that I appreciate, but the app on the phone is pretty basic, but you do get to see sort of the most important things. So I get to see my network map so that I have my router connected to my satellite, and I can also see what devices are connected to each and the connection they get. So if they get 5 gigahertz or 2.4 gigahertz, I can see all of that over here in an easy to use dashboard. I can even disconnect certain devices if I want. So it's basically all you need. I can even run a speed test from over here. It's just fine, to be honest. Now, the question that I'm going to ask myself is, would I recommend the Orbi to others? And the answer is an astounding yes, because if you have a bigger than average apartment or bigger than average house, you're going to need a distributed Wi-Fi system, and the Orbi is one of the best. But even if you can't afford the Orbi, just go with the mesh system that you find online that has good reviews, because it's going to be much, much better than a single router which would broadcast 5 gigahertz signal in the same room and maybe the room next to it. But other than that, all devices would connect to 2.4 gigahertz, and that's just not a great experience. With the mesh Wi-Fi system, you can make sure that most of your devices are on 5 gigahertz, and it's going to make the experience much, much better. Basically, with 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi, you feel much, much less like you're on Wi-Fi and much more like you're on Ethernet, because with 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi, there's only 3 non-overlapping channels, and you can sort of imagine what chaos there is in an apartment building or dense neighborhood where there's a lot of routers broadcasting all over the place, and it just means that you're going to get worse and worse speed. Because remember, there's not only interference between devices on the same network, but also neighboring networks. So that's something to keep in mind. But in the end, I'm really happy with the Orbi. Something that remains to be seen is how good Netgear support is going to be, because I've read quite a few bad stories about the firmware upgrades, but I'm hoping for the best on that one, because lately they seem to have been getting their stuff together with the upgrades, and I'm just hoping that the next updates are not going to be buggy. Anyways, guys, if you like this video, make sure to click the like button down below, subscribe for more videos like these ones, and of course comment down below with your thoughts. So thank you guys for watching. Peace out, guys. Peace.